Hey, do you know why marketers make terrible doctors? Because they can find everyone else's pain points, but they still can't cure their own. I'm talking about marketing reports. You probably have to make them every quarter, month, or every now and then. But every time a request from your boss or notification from the calendar comes, it catches you by surprise, and you find yourself having to work overtime to finish the report by the deadline. However, there's a solution. A little vitamin D can make your life as a marketer easier, reduce anxiety levels, and improve sleep. And by D, I mean dashboard. Let me show you some examples to illustrate what insights you can get when the data is visualized properly. In general, these dashboards will help you understand what is going on with your ads on specific or all your platforms, help you make data-driven decisions at a glance, check the health of your marketing funnel, and much more. So, let's get started. The Facebook Ads dashboard gives you a comprehensive overview of your ad campaign performance, from the clicks they bring to the costs you incur. But let's focus on the frequency meter. Frequency refers to the number of times a single person views your ad, which can be an important factor in optimizing a campaign. If the frequency is below 3 to 5, users haven't seen your ad enough times to engage. However, if the frequency exceeds 8 to 9, users may become annoyed and consider the ad as spam. The dashboard automatically tracks the frequency of Facebook ads across your entire account. You can also apply filters to track the frequency of individual campaigns, ad sets, or specific periods. The frequency meter is especially valuable when an agency or a freelancer manages your ads. It's a quick quality checker for the overall ad setup. Just look at it to understand if it's time to contact your contractor and ask to change the campaign settings. This dashboard is a ready-to-use reporting solution that only requires connecting your Facebook Ads account. The built-in Coupler.io connector loads your data into the dashboard, and you can analyze your results in a matter of minutes. Check the link in the description to get this dashboard. This LinkedIn Ads dashboard allows you to analyze campaign performance and conversions more efficiently and conveniently than the native LinkedIn Campaign Manager. All key metrics are available at your fingertips and are shown compared to the previous period. You can filter data by each campaign to gain a more in-depth view of their performance. This dashboard also has a frequency meter that we discussed earlier. As the ultimate goal of LinkedIn ads is to bring you impressions that must be converted into leads, the best part of this dashboard is the tab dedicated to conversions and leads. First, you can choose a conversion type from the drop-down list to see its dynamic over time. Then, check the performance of each campaign in the table below. You can sort data by impressions, conversions, amount spend, or any other parameter that is important for you. But let's scroll down to the funnel that visualizes how many impressions turned into lead form opens and eventually leads. You can see the funnel for each campaign using this drop-down menu. Also, compare campaigns side by side in the table below. I'll leave a link in the description if you want a copy of this dashboard. Follow the instructions in the README section to fill this template with your data. Brand awareness is one of those crucial marketing metrics that everyone wants to know, but often finds challenging to measure. Surprisingly, even the simplest dashboards can be incredibly helpful and insightful. This cross-channel report puts ad impressions from Facebook and branded impressions from Google Search Console on one chart. The logic behind this solution is simple. You run campaigns on Facebook, customers remember your brand's name, and then Google it. So if your brand awareness ad campaign is successful, you will see an increase in branded search volume. Keep in mind that an increase in branded impressions may not be immediate. It can take up to a month before the effect shows. To put that into context, let's say you advertise an athletic goods store to a specific group of customers. Some might not be interested in the proposal right now, but if they see the ad frequently enough and it catches their attention, they will recall the store's name once they decide to go to the gym or start running. With this dashboard, you can compare and identify correlations, or absence of correlations, in Facebook ads impressions and the branded search volume. With this insight, you can see how brand awareness changes over time and which ad campaigns drive growth. Try to filter data by a specific campaign and analyze the graphs to see the impact on brand awareness. This will help you understand which campaigns contribute to increasing brand awareness and which are less successful. Now you can reallocate your budgets to the best performing campaigns, analyze their success factors, and apply these best practices to enhance other campaigns. For example, replicate the best performing approach to ad creatives or audience settings. You can easily set this dashboard up in less than 3 minutes and get a ready-to-use analytics solution. Check the link in the description. There is a famous quote by John Wanamaker that says, "Half the money I spend on advertising is wasted. The trouble is, I don't know which half." Well, if Mr. Wanamaker had this dashboard, he would finally understand what works and what doesn't in his marketing efforts. This PPC multi-channel dashboard pulls data from different ad sources like Google Ads, LinkedIn Ads, Facebook Ads, and other platforms to let you monitor and compare campaign performance in one place. You won't need to hop between app interfaces to export data for your reports. Just connect the needed ad accounts and start analyzing the performance of your campaigns. One look will be enough to understand, how much do I spend on advertising on multiple platforms? How many clicks do I get on my advertising on all platforms? How much does one click cost me on average? It's a huge time saver, but my favorite feature is the ability to compare ad platform performance side by side to find out what works and what does not. Let's say you use the same video as an ad on Instagram and TikTok. As you can see, Instagram provided more impressions and a slightly higher number of clicks than TikTok. While a budget of under $100 is not significant, if you decide to invest $1,000 in advertising the video in the future, it would be wise to allocate most of that budget to Instagram. You can go even further and compare 3 or 4 different platforms to allocate your marketing budget wisely. Thousands of our customers love this dashboard for a reason. Start using it for free and you will soon understand why. We also have a great video tutorial on adding conversion to this dashboard and making it even better. I will leave the tutorial and dashboard links in the description below. Pipedrive Customer Acquisition Dashboard is like the PPC dashboard I showed you before, but on steroids. It pulls data from all major ad platforms like Facebook Ads, LinkedIn Ads, and Google Ads, and combines them with the sales data from Pipedrive and Google Analytics. This lets you track not only how many users saw your ads, but also how many transformed into leads. For better understanding, this dashboard uses a multi-source funnel, where the data is structured into impressions and clicks gathered from ad platforms, new users that we got from Google Analytics, and leads provided by Pipedrive. You can see conversion rates between each step. It helps identify weaknesses in your marketing strategy and areas for improvement. To put this data into context, suppose this company is advertising their consultancy services. The first problem is that over 1 million people saw their ad, and only a fraction clicked. Maybe the company should choose ad platforms more carefully and tweak demographic settings because they are probably wasting most of their budget now. The ratio between clicks and new users could be better. They should definitely check the copy or structure on the landing pages. For sure, each domain has its specifics. Compare each stage's conversion rates with your industry benchmarks to identify funnel leaks. If your rates are far below average, develop and test hypotheses to improve them. This way, you can drive more revenue from your existing pipeline. Also, you can use this dashboard to predict the future. Leverage historical data to build sales forecasts for future ad investments. For example, predict the number of leads you could generate by doubling your ad spend. We also have a similar dashboard for HubSpot. You can start using them for free. Check the links in the description. Let's look at one more dashboard with a funnel, this time made for e-commerce. Let's focus on new customers, the purchases made in your Shopify store. Let's say you're selling custom-designed board game tables and running a Google Ads campaign targeting board game enthusiasts aged 25 to 45. your funnel shows 50,000 impressions, 2,500 clicks, and 1,000 new users, but only 15 new customers. The conversion rate from new customers to customers is 1.5%. This low rate suggests that while your ad attracts interest, something on your website is deterring purchases. You might hypothesize that the product images don't showcase the table's features well, the customization options are overwhelming, or the shipping costs are too high. Test these hypotheses by improving product photography, simplifying customization, or offering free shipping promotions to boost your conversion rate. And it's not the only insight you can gain from this report. Scroll down to check the data for impressions, clicks, and number of orders. This data will help you understand how ad spending translates into sales. Let's take a closer look at the chart showing the monthly ratio between advertising costs and revenue generated by sales. It looks good currently, but if advertising spending is growing while sales are going down, that's a wake-up call. With the insights from the Shopify dashboard, you can make data-driven decisions and boost your e-commerce store's performance. To start using it for free, check the link in that description. Now, I will show you the all-in-one marketing dashboard that offers a performance overview of your marketing efforts across multiple channels. It collects data from Google Analytics, Google Search Console, advertising platforms, social media apps, email tools, and YouTube. It allows you to track the performance of paid ads, organic search, social media, and email campaigns in a single interface. Let's start from the top. All Channels Performance Overview provides a high-level summary of the website traffic and total revenue, a chart with data divided by months, and a pie chart showing each category's share in overall traffic. Scroll down to track the performance of your PPC marketing through key metrics like amount spent, impressions, clicks, cost per click, and click-through rate. The table shows the monthly performance for all paid channels, but you can use the filter to see the results for each of them, like Google Ads or LinkedIn Ads. The section focused on organic search performance is located below. It lets you track impressions, clicks, CTR, and average position based on the data from Google Search Console. You can also filter data by session source, such as Google, Yahoo, Bing, etc. Next, you can get a detailed breakdown of how your social media channels are performing. This section tracks impressions and page views across all sources. You can filter the results by a specific source using the drop-down list. In this section, you can see the performance of your YouTube channel, including metrics like views, watch time, and engagement on your videos. It provides insight into how your video content is performing on its own and whether it contributes to your overall marketing strategy. Also, you can monitor the effectiveness of your email marketing campaigns in Klaviyo and MailChimp. This section displays key metrics such as emails delivered, open rate, bounces, unsubscribes, and clicks. With this information, you can evaluate the success of your email outreach and optimize for higher engagement. In my humble opinion, it's a must-have dashboard for any marketing manager or business owner. Check the link in the description to grab it. Speaking of YouTube, for some businesses, it can be a crucial source of leads. However, it's also true that it is hard to understand how many customers are coming to your website by clicking the link in the video description. But hard doesn't mean impossible. This Google Sheets dashboard visualizes data from GA4 and displays metrics for the traffic coming to your website only from YouTube. The key dimension of a dashboard is a website's landing pages. The dashboard shows how users who came from YouTube to specific pages behave on your website, how long they stay there, whether they make a purchase, or perform any actions or key events. That means events that you mark as important in GA4. Sort data by clicks, e-commerce purchases, and purchase revenue to see which website pages produces the best results. If you know in which videos you use the links to these pages, you can try launching a promo or ads for these videos, or produce more such content that drives results. Also, there is a version of this dashboard for Looker Studio, but it has some limitations due to the specifics of Looker Studio API. I will leave a link to both versions in the description below. Wondering how much traffic you get from your social media platforms? There's a dashboard for that. It combines Facebook, Instagram, LinkedIn, YouTube, and GA4 data. As a result, you will better understand whether your social media activity brings any results and what channels are the most effective. The dashboard also provides a performance breakdown of last month's dynamics per social media platform. This way, you can track your social media efforts across multiple platforms in one place. That will be extremely useful for marketing managers. Now you have a better understanding of what marketing analysis is, along with several useful dashboards in your toolbox. This is only a fraction of the dashboard templates for marketing, sales, and finance available at Coupler.io. I'll leave the link in the description. If you have any questions or requests for future videos, feel free to ask them in the comments. If you enjoyed this video, please give us a like, share the video with others, and subscribe to our channel so you never miss a thing. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.